Okay, so I have, this is a question from Instagram. I have read all the series of The Secret many times, including The Greatest Secret. My question is, even after awareness, which is The Greatest Secret, I'm finding it difficult to manage one strong belief that I have, that if I miss an opportunity, which matters a lot to me, then it takes years to get me another opportunity. How should I tackle this belief and manifest a new belief? Well, you know, there's two ways that you can do this, but I just think if you just let that belief go, the first thing that's so amazing and that I want to congratulate you for is that you've realized that's a belief. That's fantastic. Because when you can see that something is a belief, you have actually collapsed half of that belief, half of it. So, I mean, that's amazing. And now all you have to do is have the other half go away too. So what I'm going to suggest to you is so that you, that belief can just completely be gone, and you don't have to replace it with another belief, because once it's gone, it's gone. Now, there are two ways. You could create another belief to override it, and that's what is in The Secret. You think lots of positive thoughts, and then that will override the old belief. But you have to kind of stay on that track of thinking those positive thoughts. You can't let the other thoughts come in, otherwise the old belief will begin to override again. So my suggestion is, let's just take that belief out. Let's cut it, right? And for anybody who has any belief that they don't want, like, for example, I'm limited. There are only a certain number of things that I can do. I can't do that. I can't do anything that I want. I can't have anything that I want. I can't be anything that I want. If you have any of those beliefs, then you could do this too. So all you need to do is welcome the belief that you don't want. And for this person, this is what you're really going to find interesting, is that this person says that they have a belief that they're finding it difficult to manage one strong belief, that if I miss an opportunity, which matters a lot to me, then it takes years to get another opportunity. So the belief that the person has is, if I miss an opportunity, which matters a lot to me, right? And so what I want you to do, and I wish I could say your name, but it's Meheta Forum, whatever that is. So what I want you to do, and this is what my teacher would say to me, welcome wanting to miss opportunities that matter a lot to you. And you're like, what? But if you welcome wanting to miss opportunities that matter a lot to you, and then welcome the feelings that you have of wanting to regress, and welcome any feelings of regression. Now, that seems totally contradictory, right? But let me explain, because it's not. Why would you want to miss opportunities that matter a lot to you? Well, actually, the fact that you have a belief of that means that somehow you have thoughts that got into your subconscious mind that formed a belief. And you know that, otherwise you wouldn't have this belief at all. And so you definitely have it. Your subconscious mind thinks you want this, thinks you want it. It's got it all wrong, but it got some thoughts in it, and it just accepted it. And it was maybe when you were a child, or you heard somebody say something and you just accepted it. And so that's how we know that we need to take this belief out. And if you welcome wanting to miss opportunities that matter a lot to you, if you welcome it, you release it. You release it. So welcoming is just like opening up like this, welcoming with your arms out kind of like this, and just welcoming that. And when you welcome that, you are releasing that belief. It's so incredible. Really, it's so easy. It's worth the effort. It really is worth it, because any negative subject, any negative feelings, any belief that you don't want, that's it. That's the one practice. That's why it's in The Greatest Secret, in my latest book, The Greatest Secret. This is the most important thing you could ever do. I've been doing it now since I met my teacher, which was in 2016. I just don't have, I can't even find a belief. I'd love to find one. I'd love to find one because I'd love to get it, you know. But everything that we're experiencing is because somehow our subconscious mind thinks we want it. Incredible, right? There are some things we don't want at all, but our subconscious mind thinks we do want it. We have inadvertently believed something. So that's why you welcome wanting something you absolutely don't want, because you're releasing the hidden beliefs that are causing it, you see. It's interesting, isn't it? It's kind of a reverse. But it's what you have to do with the subconscious mind. And you can kind of, I wish I could remember an instance where my teacher said to me, one will come to me. I remember talking to her and she would say, welcome. I would say, I don't like the feeling of fear. And she would say, welcome wanting the feeling of fear. And I'd be like, no, I don't want it. She's like, no, you have to welcome not wanting it. Because look, no, I don't want it. You're pushing it away. And guess what? You're going like that. You're not going like that. You're going like that. And you're pushing it down inside of you, super gluing it to you.